Θα το μα. Θα μόνο λίγα. Άρα τη λίγη τσέμπρι. Σουγγουή.
First of all, I would like to wish you all a good morning.
Ana kazang trade ma. Gadusin.
And I will continue from where we left off yesterday. At the second paragraph on page 4.
Nge sambala panje khoye du nge sambala jege jibu zobe sangye jubala so pa de me ba so ge sonam khanji serwala la len che ge ban du nyam songji che be di so ya nambu ji le be che na che shin a zong gi kon ge du ju ne ma so ro shin du che na
In my opinion, we must flee the suffering of samsara that is to be eliminated. We must accumulate incalculable accumulations to achieve the result, perfect Buddhahood. I think we must practice whatever is said to be the greatest merit. If even when selling something such as woolen cloth, we let the other win by 4 or 5 pounds without them knowing, I think it will bring great merit.
Tadi kare sungu yare shubina. Ane nga poto we samnas. Aju dene pangja kowe dungye de pangja res. Jezan tele chwe kongtu pangja te dang rengi le ta sing kongtu chiabi. Gyangda kachu jige rengi le ya.
So what this is saying is that in my Potoa's opinion, we need to eliminate the suffering of samsara. And so for that reason, as much as we possibly can, we must get as much distance as we can between ourselves and those that suffering to be eliminated. Up until now, we have experienced the sufferings of samsara, even though we have not wanted to experience them. The question is, who has fooled us into suffering these, into experiencing this suffering? It has been our attachment and fixation on the pleasures and tasks of this life. It is our fixation upon this life that has fooled us. And so it is our fixation, our attitude of being fixated on this life that is to blame.
Namo Bhagavate Sumero Kalbarajaya Dandagadaya Arhate Samya Sambuddhaya Diyata Om Kalbe Kalbe Maha Kalbe Kalbe Jodhani Soya
Rain, you sane, sendele chaji shenbe lon di ngazu tadaba do mandu shindo dunge nyong chukba yindu sane di gyunzengi sendele chaji shenbe lo de bongu resam tengdoos.
And so this attitude of fixation and attachment to this life has made us experience suffering unwillingly up until now. And so therefore, I think that we need to eliminate this attitude of fixation on this life.
Nyasinyak chakyuti zemole shaj tashyores. Teta chandrawa maranzu chi kowe dunghe la jonggengi, tsamjuru chinggengi, kowe dewa tanawan de la chashishiba chigyuyawas.
It is like when we go fishing. On a fish hook, there is a little hook on the, or a spike on the end of the hook that catches the fish. And likewise, we must not be caught on the pleasures of samsara that cause us to take rebirth in samsara and experience suffering.
That is a mikashi ki tse lue tang ba yin singe de de mikashi ndus. Da tse de lue tang sha ba yin singe mikashi ndus.
These days, there are some people who say that they have given up on this life, but when we really examine them, we see that they have not really given up on this life. For example, there are some people who, first of all, become monastics. They wear the robes of a monastic and they see if they can get anyone else to respect them or think highly of them. But they don't develop any of the qualities that would lead others to respect them or think highly of them. So they take off their robes and they put on the outfit of a yogi, the clothes that one wears when you do the practices of yogas. And they go around, they grow their hair long so it goes down past their ears, and they go all over and they say, I lead a simple life, I've given up on this life. And they go and they try to see if they can become well known and famous for this. So there are so many of them. They fill many lands in this world. And so what they're trying to do is they're thinking to themselves, can I get anyone else to think highly of me? Can I get other people to respect me? And this is a sign that they have not given up on this life. So it says, we must accumulate incalculable accumulations to achieve the result, perfect Buddhahood. And so we need to do what will gather the greatest amount of merit, the vastest merit. So Poto says is that if he were to engage in business, the way he'd do it is if, for example, he were selling woolen cloth, so cloth made out of wool, what he would do is he would let the other person win or get an extra profit by about 4 or 5 pounds. This is like a pound is like half a kilo. So by 4 or 5 pounds, you'd give them that profit of 4 or 5 pounds without the other person knowing. He wouldn't want the other person to realize, oh, he gave me an extra 4 or 5 pounds. To continue with the text, when I say this, others say it is taking a loss without any return. It would be better to give, they say. Dharma practitioners should not actually want any return and should take delight when other beings who are like their father and mother win instead of themselves. If they are not like that, there is no way they will awaken to Buddhahood. It is also the opposite of meditating on the four immeasurables. And so when Potala has said what he thought to other people, what they respond is that doing business like that is only for idiots and fools. Because you're losing in business and you get no return, not only that, there's no point in this. It's better to just give it to the other. Because if you give if you actually give it to the other, then the other person will be grateful, thinking, oh, he gave that to me. So to do business like that, there's no there's no profit in the business, and because the others are unaware that they have made a profit, they don't think that they've been given anything, and so you lose on the business. You don't have any gain, and so it'd be better just to give it. They say. What Potoa is saying is that if you are fixated on this lifetime, if you only think about this lifetime, then it may well be so. You probably would have to just do this. But for Dharma practitioners, we shouldn't expect gratitude. We shouldn't expect anyone to return the favors. We should have no expectation for any response or returning of favors. It's like with parents. When parents have a child whom they dearly love, what do they want? They would prefer to have the child be victorious, or the child win out over instead of the parents. They consider they would rather have it is more important for them to have things turn out well for the child, their child, than for themselves. And so for Dharma practitioners who seek enlightenment, they are happier when others have merit than would have virtue than when they have virtue. They are happier, or they consider it more important for others to for things to go well for others than for themselves. This is the type of particular attitude that we should develop. And so one should have an attitude of preferring that others be happy than yourself be happy. And this should not be just for a few sentient beings with whom you have connections, those who are close to you. It shouldn't be that you have it only for those who are close to you and not for other sentient beings. We need to have such an attitude that is unbiased for all sentient beings, whether they are friend or enemy.
어다 대대비기 셈기 마게나 상게 토베아지 지다 요 말했다 상게 토베아지 요 말했지 제제 간다 나게 조그레스 숨으래
And he says that if we do not develop such an attitude, that there is absolutely no way that we will be able to achieve Buddhahood.
대대비고 로지 마게나 심지엔 탐지 대화다 대외 규단 대머리 주 심지엔 탐지 동야다 동해 규다 대화 교지 라소바 근데 그 세메시 공바 깨도 제바 세메시 공구 위에서 라바 이나야 다데 잠네레스 라레란 세메시 냠네 지겨마 칸네 세메시 누더 차 누더 자디어스 제자 군인이 되네 가슴 믿음 밤 Semka Madhumba Ruchik to Chadi Arasu.
If we don't develop such an attitude, we may say to ourselves, may all sentient beings be happy and have the causes of happiness. May all sentient beings be free of suffering and the causes of suffering. We may recite these four immeasurables. We might say that we're meditating upon them. We might try to meditate upon them, but actually, we're doing the opposite of this. Actually, what is happening is that our attitudes and our actions and our mind are out of sync with each other. They do not match each other. It is a sign that our words and our attitudes do not match. It is a sign that our mind is not compatible with that.
That's a zinola, Carsundusana, Zazil Penne. Sangi, Tober Chevala, Simsian, Pember, you know, Longe, Dajime, Ludan, Soyan, Don Nuguela, Songhe Reds and Pambala, Nishan Garde.
As it says in
Potomac, Nishan Garde, Yendro, Chevati, Sienata, Pemba Kala Nuna, Ranaya, Shindu Nebra, Wundi. Bebna, you do jiggy, Gilzuna, Tawa, Namaji, Tambala, Shengigan, Kongi, Gawa, Dusse, Ryan, Gawa, Cheson Yamne, you the Gomba, Dusha, Rede, so you do Nyashi, Kundu, Tongarche. I didn't remove you. Tell me, Jevata, Chetse, Sanse, Chisela, Mizeba, Rari, Sendu, Kona, Mundu, for the Dumni.
So as it says in the text, in order to achieve Buddhahood, you should be able to give even your body and your life if it will benefit sentient beings, not to mention giving away possessions. How could a practitioner who loses a couple nights' sleep when they suffer a small loss on their merchandise help anyone else? They are causing themselves great harm. For example, when people offer tea to the monks of one valley on one morning, someone else might say they have gained merit, and they themselves will think they have done something virtuous. But then they stay in a valley or monastery where many people have gathered. They buy when goods are plentiful and sell when they are scarce. They do not sell at the going rates or use quarts, ounces, and accepted measures. They keep on pushing until they achieve their wishes, not giving up until others are left powerless and unhappy and their own hopes are fulfilled. This is not just one or two people. It is all beings in the 10 directions. It is not just for one day, one month, or one year. They do it their whole lives. In brief, they feel good if they do something virtuous for one morning, but do not feel even a moment's discomfort for spending their entire lives accumulating misdeeds. I wonder what kind of a mind they have. What assurance could they have?
Longju disuda, shema wares. Jala disuda, Jimbatanga, Lutanga, shema wares. Rangi, Luda, Soya, Gobayana, Tangores.
So, what this says is that in order to achieve Buddhahood, If it is beneficial for other sentient beings, there's no need to mention giving away your own possessions, that is, giving away your things. You should be able to sacrifice even your own body or your own life if there is a purpose to it.
니네야 딘상 쳬바 디즈기 총케레 좀 판발라스 케사르 우마르 벨리아 심지엔리아 토보게 주사네 토보 예르 지 유엔르 지나 니용데르 와 데르질리아 토보질리아다 케사르 지 루스도와 다 총케레 좀 판브르 주사네 샤부카시 니먹군 당아
And so what Potoa says that these days there are some Dharma practitioners who, when they sell, when they suffer a loss on their merchandise, for example, if they have a bushel, such as if you are loading a pack on an animal, you load a pack on one side and another side, that is called a pack on an animal, the animal's pack. If you lose even that much, then they will not be able to sleep for several days. They'll be thinking to themselves, I lost all that merchandise, I've lost all this money. They'll be unable to sleep. And if the Dharma practitioner is like that, then how can they possibly accomplish Buddhahood?
No, benefit.
How can they possibly bring any benefit?
Ming lama tanendra, pavin tanendra, kembo tanendra, chuji tanendra, ming kandit tane madane, latuna do di, and sob dan jigware, sob sitizan azuji, then a simjengi, chilo the simjeng papa image. Now loco tombachin, tune some of our turn, pigay shasha, diksha, short, diminu sobs.
So that sort of person may be called by any sort of title. They may be called a lama or a kempo or a master or whatever title we give them. They are actually just like sort of like a scarecrow. If you make a scarecrow by taking the skin of an animal and stuffing it so that the inside is actually nothing, but on the outside it looks like the animal. They are just like that.
Tizus, mitizus or dizu. Negap Koranji gega toban robotile, negap colambro juban roboti ores. In a pula, Koran Pundrores, Koran labe, never shimbu yores.
That sort of person might have a temporary win, they might have a temporary gain, and things may go well for them for a while. But in the long term, they will experience loss. In the long term, it is harm for them.
Benna song da di na benna yu zhu ji ge jie zun la cha wa nang ma ji chang ba la xian ji yang kong ge ge wa zhu shi ran ge wa qi da di ka shi wo shi na long long ba ji ge chong zu ji la chong zu chung chong zu ji la jie zun shi de san da cha wa yin la min la shen ma de da Chaba yinbaya sora, minbaya sora, dinda mangbo jitsu saane, mangbo jitsu ruru suane. Adi zola, karzore, shokbe jigla. Dana doji tangmarensi ta, kalashi tangmarensi, bena breakfast doji, shokbe jigla. Nima jigla ta, shokbe jigla ya, breakfast doji, cawasini shokbe kalali cawasi korba. Dina yin dusi dana, shokbe kalaji tangmarensi.
で、登住さんね、身近だ。これ人だと言うし。え、これ職場からしたんです。登住さんの身近だけ、お、たくもね、業は渋滞してそうだ、さ。身近だけ楽です。コランけ、単に落ちてそうなのを知ってんです。てにげまんじゃたん。だ。現住様に人ごりやぼちゃえそうなのをコランが知ってんです。 So it says here, for example, when people offer tea to the monks of one valley on one morning, someone else might say they have gained merit, and they will think they have done something virtuous. So this is, they'll gather a group of monks, and here monks means not just monks, but also sort of fake monks. They'll gather anyone who looks like a monk, and then they will give them breakfast, or they'll give them food for one morning. They'll give them tea or food for one morning. And then by giving this, then other people will say, oh, this is a sponsor. Look, they've done some incredible merit. They've done a great merit through this. And that person will themselves think, oh, I've done something that's really pretty good. I gave some tea. I gave some breakfast to the Sangha. So what these people think is that up to now I've gathered all these things and I've given some of it now, but I'm never going to.
No, not think, they say. Those people say. Not just thinking.
Oh, so people say to them, there's everything you've gathered, all the wealth you've gathered in this life, and now you've given some. Now in the future, don't give any more.
Not like that. He's saying that whatever I collected, I always donated to. There, and the future also.
So what these people say is that in the past, everything they have gathered, they have given towards the Dharma. In the future, they will also give to the Dharma for the sake of the Dharma. Or the future, they will not give. And then other people criticize them, and then they get rather angry, and they start scowling at people. They get proud and haughty over what they've done. They boast of what they've done. But they start scowling so that they start looking like a demon, like one of the henchmen of Yama, the lord of death, and they're scowling with this big black face. So then they go someplace else. They go to another valley or another monastery where there are many people who gather there. And when goods and things are plentiful in that area, then they buy them on the cheap. And when they are scarce, then they sell them.
Mishigal, Takantra, Chitana, somebody, or the Mishigan, Rigbana, Rigbatan. Midsama, Samba Mugi, Dingy, tinde sugudus. Ta? Kanda tinde chene uzugem. Ta kuyo karasi orasi na, nye tinda minsi orba. Nye tsongyari nye tinda minsi. Di lama gindunda tinde chedu yinsi chedu. Ka di tena ta ne. En tinde chede gus.
And then the way that they do business is that they don't follow the accepted prices. Like in a region, there might be accepted prices for various goods and services, but they don't follow these, and they set their own prices. And then they insist that they get their prices, and they won't sell anything until they get the prices. They do everything they can to make the other people unhappy and depressed. They're so insistent about it that they won't give up until the other people have just been worn down and give in. They think of various ways that they can do this. They're very clever, and they try to think of the cleverest ways that they can possibly get what they want. And so by following this, they do everything they can to make other people unhappy, to make other people really disappointed from their debts. And then they say to themselves, I'm not doing this for me. I'm doing this for the benefit of the gurus and the sangha.
Dijegi lega chedengi, di miji de ni ni mares. Ani, ane, sonso de jiru de miji de ni juju de. Ata ke lega chadi de, juju robos lagu ayu zin de pasi de imra. Tadi ke chongye du san mi jiru ni de la di chigi amares. Midirin yiri chibu maris. Da, anda cho tamse ni mi kandish leyo na, rungbatili mi kandish leyo na, tela kubi nima takwa aris, tena si chedi ga aris. Cheta di yabu maris. Mi tsangwa lo, jigi, disturb, jigi, semdi, disturb sena dhado, sempa chuk chuk mi, di yabu maris. Da, nan singi nima chigda nini maris, mi zi shibu di lega tindri yendu jangga chen, di ya aris, di yabu maris.
So this is just an example. When people do this sort of job, they don't just do it just for one day or not. They don't do it to just one or two people. It is to all beings in these 10 directions. This means, when saying it's for all beings in the 10 directions, this means that they don't do it to just one or two people. It's whoever comes, any being who comes. They do the same thing. Treat them in the same way every day. They do everything they can to get what they want, and they end up depressing or disturbing and upsetting other people. And this is not good. When they do this, they don't do it for just one day or one or two days. They do it for their entire lives, and this is not good.
Shobe chilia, doa. Ta shobe chilia, kandun du chichene, doa. Kandun to sen ta tiring, nye kandun doing, yamlin chain, cheche, lo debo chen. Ta du do you some tendy doos?
So the main point is that when we do something virtuous, for example, we get up the morning and we recite some prayers or we do some practice. We think to ourselves, oh, I did some practice, I recited some prayers, and we feel good about it. But if we spend our entire lives doing misdeeds, then we don't feel bad about it at all. And so we wonder. So Potoa wonders what sort of mind, what sort of heart these people have, what sort of assurance can they have? To continue reading from the text, the way that they have come under the control of ego clinging and desire, there's no need to speak of them being liberated in the misdeeds, lack of inherent existence. First of all, they haven't even heard that misdeeds ripen as rebirth in the three lower realms in the next life. Even if they have heard, they do not think of it. Instead, without shrinking from ill repute in this life and suffering in the next, they are able to sacrifice everything, their body, life, and dharma. If it seems they might gain some riches, they deserve our compassion. That is the epitome of wallowing in the causes of suffering. Now what this saying here is that at the time of Potowa, and also at the time of Mikyo Dorje, there are various different titles that were given to Dharma practitioners. Sometimes they are called practitioners, sometimes they are called siddhas, or they are called jetsun, the venerable yogis. They would be called the omniscient. They might be called incarnations or tulkus. So here, incarnations and tulkus are a little bit different. The incarnation would be like the rebirth of a being, and the tulku would be like the emanation of their body, speech, and mind. Or they would be called the lords of victors, the gyawans, or they would be called the chatangcheras, or they'd be given various other titles.
Ramjam basar the adi scholar the kepa ramjam basar penjem munra sumbas ne penjem munra jabasar ta de ming dam da mang ta shores
or the
sholog munra sum lo le yes sholog munra ja lo le yes ne mang bo ares
and so they would be called rabjampas, which is like saying a doctor. That they have a doctorate, or it'd be, they would be called panditas who have memorized 300,000 shlokas or stanzas, or panditas who have memorized 3 million stanzas.
That is what Ming Kande Tane Madena, Denjenda, Debachil, Dunzin Chilu, Debachilu, Tela, Samu Pambina.
Pazetsuzeres.
디베게 나미 세치마 나미 동에 용거래 세하지 당봉에는 고민도 없어 믿으세요 아버지 고민도 없어 코나야 디초라 삼모 땅민도 없어
So whatever title these people have, no matter how great it is, they, when we see how much clinging they have to reality, to truth, how much clinging, how much ego clinging they have, then as it says here, there's no need to speak of them being liberated in the misdeeds, lack of inherent existence. What this means is that there's no need to speak about them realizing that misdeeds are empty. And then realization, there would come liberation. There's no need to mention that. There's forget about them realizing that the misdeeds don't have inherent existence. When we look at it, first of all, they haven't even heard that misdeeds ripen as rebirth in the three lower realms in this life. They don't even know. They haven't heard this. That they ripen. Even if they have heard of this, they do not think about it. So that is enough for this morning. So next we will recite the aspiration for the stages of the path, which is on page 341 of the English book. And then we will have meditation. So yesterday we meditated for 10 minutes, but though meditating, we weren't able to meditate and couldn't help from falling asleep. If we tried to meditate, we were unable to withstand sleep. And so for that reason, today we will meditate for 5 minutes.
And tell a sim dish. And a Dachimbo Yungdone, Andy Dachimbo Yungudo Yunga tell a sim dish. Dachim Jujo don't tell my rimji sim my chop chop down to Seattle to see him.
So today, please meditate focusing on the sound of the singing bowl. Tomorrow we will focus on the breath. And so today, focus on the continuous sound of the singing bowl. And as that sound gets larger, focus on that sound growing larger. As that sound grows softer, then let your mind also become more and more subtle.
Di yuwa di, di dung du du la, ni kong na ngó dung chó, yu na. Sui ngó la ten ten min da wa ta.
So the stick, I can use it to play the singing bowl. Or I can also use it to throw at anyone who gets who falls asleep. It's uncertain who it's going to land on.
Daddy, what are you?